Hello and welcome to video lecture series in sociology. Today we are going to discuss chapter 5 titled as Change and Development in Industrial Society from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. This chapter is broadly divided into four parts. The first part deals with nature of industrial society. The second part deals with industrialization in India. The third part deals with the job market and the fourth section deals with working conditions in India. In sociology, industrial society refers to a society that uses technology for mass production and has a high degree of division of labor. Industrial society developed in the West with Industrial Revolution and replaced the pre-modern agrarian societies of the pre-industrial age. Industrial societies are often contrasted with the pre-industrial societies. When they are contrasted, we should know what are the differences between the industrial and pre-industrial societies. Let us understand what is pre-industrial society. These societies have small-scale economies and use unsophisticated means of production for subsistence at domestic level, primarily for self-consumption. Like a rural community, it consists of a small size of population, it follows an agriculture or allied activity, and here people have primary, intimate, face-to-face, personal and informal relationships. Unlike the pre-industrial, in industrial societies, large-scale production is done with use of technology. Mass production is done in factory and the output is sold in the market to generate profit. Even labor power is bought and sold like commodities in these markets. It consists of relatively large size of population, follows non-agricultural occupations. The social relationships in industrial societies are non-intimate, impersonal, indirect, formal, and secondary in nature. How do we define a particular type of society? Simply stating, what a society does for a living, that determines the nature of social life of that particular society. And that defines a society as industrial, agricultural, or pre-industrial or traditional type of society. Industrial society came into existence with industrialization. And industrialization as a process of change was set in by Industrial Revolution. There is no exact date on which Industrial Revolution began. Roughly, it began around the middle of the 18th century in England and spread rapidly to other parts of Europe and gradually to rest of the world. Industrialization changed the production process, the way economy was organized, and provided employment to large number of people in factories during that time. The early sociologists were influenced by these changes happening due to industrialization in Europe. They were concerned about issues of social order and social change, as industrial and French revolutions had radically transformed the nature and structure of society and social relationships. These social, economic and political changes led to emergence of a new society with great productive potential and sophisticated and complex ways of living. However, it also disturbed the traditional structures, relationships and created new problems of poverty and unemployment. In Europe, with change in economic structure, large number of people migrated from rural areas to cities or urban areas in search of jobs and settled down around factories, which led to emergence of cities and industrial towns. Let us discuss some of the important social, economic and political effects of Industrial Revolution and industrialization and how it altered the nature and character of European society and gradually all over the world. Talking about the economic changes, the Industrial Revolution led to introduction of factory system where mass production of goods was being done in big industries or factories. It led to increase in consumption and change in the standard of living. It also led to rise of industrial capitalism and later on expansion of world trade. Talking about the political changes brought about by the Industrial Revolution, it led to decline of feudalism or agrarian social structures. It led to growth of democracy and industrial nations became dominant. There was also a rise of a capitalist class that traded and had control over the business. Talking about the social changes, Industrial Revolution and development in science and technology and health benefits, there was a rise in population. Growth and development of city was a consequence of the growth of population. There was also a process of migration leading to mixing of cultures and emergence of homogeneous cultures world over. New forms of stratification also emerged. And interestingly, Women also came out of their households and started working in industries. But these changes also led to a large number of problems. Problems such as economic inequality, poverty, development of urban slums, unemployment, and environmental hazards. Worst was development of weapons for war, which led to massive destruction during the two world wars, as we have already seen. According to Raymond Aron, industrial society can be defined as a society in which large-scale industry is the characteristic form of production. A number of other features are also related to the basic definition of industrial society, such as the industrial enterprise is separate from the domestic economic activity. An industrial firm introduces technical division of labor within the firm. An industrial enterprise implies an accumulation of capital that is invested for running and expanding the enterprise and generating profits. Industrial societies in general are characterized by rational calculation as it involves large amount of capital. There is also concentration of labor in the workplace and there is formal relationship between management and the workers. The production of goods using inanimate sources of energy and machines in large-scale industry requires a certain set of skills among people to run the machinery. This distribution of skill affects the nature of stratification in industrial society, such as there is a distinction between skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled workers that determines their social status according to their educational qualifications and the level of skill they have. There are issues and problems related to motivation, coordination and management of people as well. To understand industrial societies, we need to analyze two things. The first, the historical development of industrial societies, and secondly, the organization of work in the industry, that is how and what is the nature of labor market, which means how is social labor organized and administered, what tools and technologies or implements are available to the workers, and who owns the capital and the land. Many of the great works of sociology have attempted to analyze nature of industrial society. The early sociologists explained the new industrial age by comparing it with the pre-industrial societies and identifying its core characteristics. For example, for Karl Marx, the modern industrial age was characterized by industrial capitalism. In fact, Marx was critical of capitalism. He argued that the wealth or profits created in the industrial society remain in the hands of few people, the bourgeoisie class, who exploit the labor of the working class, that is, the proletariat class. As industrialization involves a detailed division of labor, people often do not see the end result of their work because they are producing only a small part of the product, not the entire product. This work is often repetitive and exhausting, such as in the assembly line. Yet they do it because it is better than having no work at all, that is being unemployed. Marx called this condition as alienation. When people do not enjoy the work and see it as something they have to do only in order to survive and earn. And even that survival depends on whether the technology has room for any human labor or not. Max Weber, one of the key founders of sociology, argued that modern industrial societies are characterized by a process of increasing rationalization. For Weber, rationalization means a historical drive towards a world in which one can master all things by calculation. Rationality is application of reason to achieve desired ends. It leads to greater predictability, calculability, coordination, and control in all spheres of life. In such conditions, individuals feel trapped in an iron cage with no room for creativity and understanding of the work. For Weber, industrialization is leading to progressive disenchantment. What is meant by disenchantment? You will learn more about this concept later. Emile Durkheim, another sociologist of the same time, also reflected extensively on changing nature of societies because of industrialization and urbanization. Durkheim expressed his concern about the effects of rapid changes that were happening across Europe due to industrialization and concomitant processes of social change. As other sociologists of his time, Durkheim also explored about issues of social order and social change. He argued that industrialization and other social and political changes will dissolve the restraints on behavior, causing lack of moral direction and pressure. Durkheim stated that over time, society has evolved from a primitive to a modern state. This progression has led to shift in the form of solidarity a society exhibits. Interestingly, Durkheim describes two forms of society which he differentiates on the basis of different forms of social solidarity or social cohesiveness. These two forms of social solidarity are mechanical solidarity and organic solidarity. Each of these types explain how individuals in society were united and connected to one another based upon prevalent conditions. According to Durkheim, mechanical solidarity existed in simple societies. Simple societies are small-scale, self-sufficient societies. There is little specialization, low division of labor, and individuals are not dependent upon each other for their existence. They hold similar value system. Mechanical solidarity is a result of likeness among the members or homogeneity. There is a moral consensus which binds members of the society together in mechanical solidarity. But due to rise in population, increasing specialization, and greater division of labor, these societies become complex. Complex societies are characterized by greater differences among people. This is called as organic solidarity. Organic solidarity refers to a state in which individuals and institutions become dependent upon each other in a complex division of labor. The modern industrial societies, according to Durkheim, are examples of organic solidarity, as against the pre-industrial societies or traditional societies, which are examples of mechanical solidarity. In sum, the writings of the sociologist in Europe during the 19th century reflects a concern regarding changing nature of social and cultural fabric of society due to rapid industrialization and urbanization. Along with various revolutions, social, intellectual, philosophical, the entire socio-cultural political fabric of Europe underwent transformation. While the early sociologists saw industrialization as both positive and negative because of its negative and positive consequences, obviously, by the middle of the 20th century, the modernization theory perceived industrialization as inevitable and positive. Why is it so? Why did modernization theory and other theories of social change considered industrialization as positive? We'll discuss about this in the next part of this lecture. To sum up, let's conclude what we discussed today. We discussed about the nature of industrial society. What are the features of industrial society? We distinguished between the pre-industrial and the industrial type of society, which was a consequence of the Industrial Revolution. We discussed briefly about the social, political, and economic changes brought about by the Industrial Revolution. And finally, towards the end, we discussed about the works of Karl Marx, Max Weber, and Emile Durkheim briefly, commenting on the rise of the industrial society. In the next part, we'll discuss about theories of social change and industrialization in India. Till then, you can enjoy reading this part of the chapter.